On parle de pêche durable et raisonnable, et derrière
people
ces termes,
talk about
on
sustainable
des problèmes
fishing,
de pression un peu
but this
trop
means
forte
that
de pêche,
we exert excessive pressure on the marine resources in terms of quantity,
qualité,
but also in terms of quality. And all
donc
of the
problème,
species
le
being caught. And the question is, do the fishers always
Alors,
catch the,
en fait,
do the fishermen always catch the fishes they were targeting? For instance, we have target species and accessory fish species. When a ship sails, it sails to catch one or more targeted species.
Mais de manière accidentelle, avec
but accidentally, with the net, it catches other species which were not targeted, and those are called accessory species. Therefore, the catch of a fishing ship is the total sum of target species and accessory species.
A
given species is not considered automatically as a target species or an accessory species. It depends on the motivation of the fisherman, the type of fishing. Take the example of purse seiners catching listau tuna fishes. They will catch mahi-mahi accidentally, catch this other fish called mahi-mahi, whereas coastal fishermen will sail to catch mahi-mahi fishes and will catch a listau tuna fish accidentally. So fish species are not target or accessory species. It depends on who fishes them. Now, the question is, catching accidentally a non-targeted species, is that acceptable and sustainable? It depends very much on the species, on the quantity, and on what happens to the accessory catches. Let us place ourselves under the angle of the ecosystemic approach, because traditionally the objective has always been to manage target species populations. Tuna fishing is all about managing tuna populations, but the ecosystemic approach showed that we could not limit ourselves to the management of target species, but also we should care for accessory species. How do we do that? Well, the first step consists in listing all the fishes being caught. This means that we have to send observers on board the ships in order to identify all of the species being captured, measuring their size and counting how many fishes are caught. Take the theoretical composition of the catch of a given fishing ship. Well, we have the target species, the reason why the ships originally sailed. Then part of the catch will be made of accessory species, which will be kept on board, either to be eaten by the crew, or because these fishes can also be sold. There are accessory species which will be thrown back into the sea because they cannot be sold, or there may be a category of species which are endangered species, and they also will be thrown back into the sea. What are the management objectives? There are two categories here: accessory species thrown back into the sea. Now, the rule will be to keep them on board, first of all, for a matter of food safety, because we need to make sure that nothing is wasted. And also the other stake is preservation. We should avoid excessive mortality on endangered species, and we should remain careful not to put them at greater risk. Fishing several species, is that a problem? The Convention for Biological Diversity tells us that one key element of the ecosystemic approach consists in preserving the structure and the operation of the ecosystem. Now, one of the paradigms that was applied in most fisheries across the world was precisely to try and apply good selectivity in the fishing nets and fishing gear. Is that compatible with the preservation of the ecosystem? What is selectivity? Selectivity is a process whereby fishing will produce a catch with a different composition from that existing in the natural habitat. All fishing gears are selective. Now, the danger is that this selectivity becomes inappropriate. And if the fishing pressure is excessive, this leads to changes in the ecosystem, And this is precisely what we want to avoid.
Alors, tout cela nous amène à considérer le concept d'exploitation
équilibrée. We need to think about
en fait,
a balanced type of exploitation. We should exploit the ecosystem based on its natural structure and operation. We need to consider all of the species, all of the sizes, and match them with the natural production. The whole idea consists in changing the current system, which was based on managing populations. We exploited a given type of population, but we shouldn't do that. We should exploit the ecosystem and all of the species in the ecosystem. And this is where we need to go towards in order to have sustainable fishing strategies. Also, endangered species should be protected, marine mammals, turtles, birds, or sharks. We absolutely must eliminate fishing mortality for those species. Let us focus on sharks for a few minutes. Sharks are not so well known, and sharks have a very specific biology. Sexual maturity comes late, gestation is very long, several months, and a female will produce very few offspring during her life. So biology is very different from that of other fishes, teleostial fishes, and this biology doesn't allow the shark to reproduce very fast and therefore to sustain exploitation, and very quickly shark populations will be overfished. We need to find ways, management ways to decrease accidental capture of sharks. For long lines equipped with hooks, normally the bait are squid, and by replacing the squid with fishes, we can reduce by one third the number of sharks being caught accidentally. More generally, we must adopt good practices. When fishermen sail to sea, they must adopt good practices, identify the species, and when they find an endangered fish, they should be able to throw the fish back into the sea in alive. Therefore, fishermen need help so that they can implement sustainable methods, not only by adjusting the fishing pressure, but also by considering that they are going to exploit an ecosystem with several species, and that the ecologic status of each species must be taken into consideration, and that fishing habits must be adjusted to the species being caught.